everyone. My name is Scott Lambiese, and welcome back to Town Manager's Corner. As hopefully you are all aware of now, we're taping these segments, Abington Cable and myself, Kevin Tocci, and we've been doing this. I've been going out, meeting with different departments and department heads, and really the purpose of it is to help you become aware of who the department heads are in town, what we're doing, what sort of issues we're facing, projects we might have going, and just sort of a general introduction. So with that, I'd like to thank Chief John Nuttall for inviting me down to the fire station. It's actually the first time in quite a while that I've been in here. So thanks for having me, Chief.
Well, thank you for coming. And right now we're at the headquarters station. We're in the apparatus floor, which normally is filled with all of the apparatus. Right now it seems very spacious because all of the apparatus, at least for today's shift, is currently operating out of Station 2 because of the road construction going on out front with Route 18. You may hear that in the background once in a while. And if you look outside, you're going to see massive equipment as they're tearing up in front of the station. We've been coordinating with the Mass DOT when they're going to be doing this so that we have time to relocate the resources as needed.
Yeah, sort of reminds me back to the days of the Big Dig. It's our own little Route 18 Big Dig. But again, could you tell me a little bit about yourself and you know, how long you've been with the town and you know, how you came up becoming chief?
Sure. I was born and raised in Abington. I grew up in Abington, Abington Schools. I still reside in Abington. I've been on the Abington Fire Department since 1990, so I've been here 30 years. I became captain around 2003. I became the fire chief in 2010, and it's been a great ride so far. We still got a few years to go, and we still have a few big projects I'm hoping to get done prior to that time, but it's a great town, it's a great department, we have great employees, great residents in the town, and we've come a long way with, you know, the assets that we have. We're a small but very busy department in the South Shore.
Yeah, and could you tell me, we just had finally it was nice to have this great experience at the Selectman meeting the other night, where you recognized some individuals, and can you just touch upon that? Because that
Absolutely.
Really was great.
Absolutely, thank you. It went a little bit rushed, because we're trying to, with the whole COVID limitations that we have, we tried to limit the people coming in. Normally, you know, if you've seen past Selectman's meetings when we've done this, we fill that entire second floor with members of the Abington Fire Department and their family. We couldn't do that this time, which is new for us. So we had Deputy Fire Chief Ron Howe retired after 34 years. He retired in May of this year, and we really couldn't do anything formal for him, again, because of the limitations. So we wanted to recognize him, and through his retirement, that created positions of growth. We had to refill the deputy's position, so a captain bumped up to deputy chief. A firefighter moved up to the position of captain, and that ultimately created a firefighter's position, which was filled with our newest member, Lily Janity. She's our first hire we've had in 5 years.
Wow.
You know, we have a good retention of the employees here, which speaks well for just, I think, the environment of the town, which is also important because there's a lot of training experience with that.
Yeah.
You know, firefighters, it's not only knowing how to, you know, be a paramedic, how to put the fires out, but you need to know your equipment, and you really need to know the buildings in town, because every building's different, every sprinkler system is different, and that takes a lot of experience to learn that.
Yeah.
So we really want to try to retain those employees for that reason.
Now, because it's so topical right now, though, obviously we're in the middle of a pandemic, or hopefully near the very tail end of a pandemic, but we'll see. Tell me, how has that affected your department?
We completely retooled the Abington Fire Department beginning in March because of the pandemic. Obviously, we're in the absolute front lines. The paramedics are in the front lines. I'm not. The paramedics are, and my respect goes to them, because they're literally taking the sick and symptomatic patients with this, in some cases positive patients that we found out, to the hospital. They're in the back of the ambulance in a very tight, closed environment with that. We recognize that immediately. How to protect our employees, how to protect the patient from spreading that from any place else. And then we had a major decontamination procedure we had to do. We're used to cleaning the ambulance after different calls anyway, but this was a little bit different. We literally retooled how we operate in this department, because every single potential incident that we respond to, whether it's a sick person, whether it's a motor vehicle accident, whether it's a fire alarm, anything, everybody potentially could have the coronavirus. Yeah. And we kind of had to assume that. So that changed every aspect of how we had to respond. We actually reassigned two paramedics to day shifts, and they really became the point men, not only for this department, but really for the town of Abington, with coordinating with the Board of Health, assisting with the police officers, because they were right behind us. They had to kind of change their tactics with this as well. They became a little bit more defensive, and we took the lead on some things because we had more equipment and training with that. It worked out very well. It dovetailed perfectly. But these two firefighter paramedics that were temporarily assigned to days for about a month and a half, we literally rewrote procedures that we became the model, I think, for so many area towns in the South Shore of how to deal with this. I'm very proud of the accomplishments that this department and those two, our two EMS coordinators, Justin Silver and Adam Levine, that really took the reins on that and ran with it.
And speaking of that, I know you have a lot of great individuals work here, but you also recognize two really good individuals who helped you secure a grant.
We did. Justin Silver was one of them,
okay. And
Kyle Guerria. They're two of our, I call them junior firefighters, although they've been here, I think, for five or eight years, time flies. And they approached me requesting permission to write a FEMA grant. That's a lot of work.
Yes, a lot is entailed in
writing these grants. And we've been very successful in writing grants for other items in the past. Deputy Glenn really has kind of been our point guy for writing the grants on that. And he assisted them. I gave them the numbers as needed, the demographic numbers within the department, the town, that they needed to do that. And they really specced out what a vehicle would be like, a theoretical vehicle would be like for us. And ultimately, they won. Yeah. So they received a positive award of $220,000 towards that project to replace the forest fire truck, which that's going to be a savings for the town of Abington residents, because that was on my capital request for a year or two out, which probably would have been $130,000 to
$150,000. Yeah, so I mean, that's amazing, and it's amazing work, because they don't just hand those grants out.
No, they're very competitive.
They're extremely competitive, and kudos to those gentlemen for working on that. That's amazing.
And that sort of rounds out the fleet. We've done it, and again, I thank the Abington residents and taxpayers. The last 10 years, since I become chief, we have replaced the ladder truck with the tower. We've replaced one engine, two ambulances, some auxiliary vehicles, more administrative, but we needed them. And now we're getting the forest fire, from a grant. But again, Abington has a small portion. They kick in for that. Three of the older engines, including this one, engine one, which is 1996 engine, these are also getting somewhat rehab. They need just some TLC. Mm-hmm. It's not a full rehab, but it's enough that we're going to get them repainted. Some of the sharp and worn edges, corroded edges on them, they're getting redone. We sent engine two out recently before that. We're in great shape apparatus-wise, equipment-wise. We've come a long way. And again, I thank the residents for that. I thank the town administration and the employees of the Abington Fire Department for really all of us working together to bring us up to where we need to be.
And so what sort of challenges do you have for the future? And we know there's one huge project that we'll be talking about in a couple minutes.
There is one final piece to this, and it really is needed. We need a new fire station. And I know that we've had the feasibility study that came out. They suggested what a building for our department would be like. I'm going to defer some of this to firefighter Derek Hamadi, who's the chairman of the building committee. He could probably talk more in depth on that. But basically, we really do need a new station. We've outgrown this, both in terms of physical space as well as just the operations. There's some health issues in these buildings. Yeah. Modern buildings separate the living quarters from the apparatus where we're at in some of the other equipment that we have. I can let Derek speak on that. But that really is the final piece that really would complete this department to keep us moving forward for the next 50 to 75 years for this town, or longer. We tend to get, we squeeze every inch of life out of our equipment and buildings, which is good. We're frugal. I'm a taxpayer. I live in town as well, and I appreciate that myself. But it's time. It really is needed. And during the pandemic, that really showed the limitations. I showed you a quick tour of the station earlier, what we have for decontamination sites. It's an old slop sink in this station. We do more of it at station two with the ambulances, but these are challenges that we have overcome. But long term, we really do need to address these.
Yeah, and I mean, you have new OSHA regulations that have come into effect, federal regulations, yes. And just, you know, I know I speak for myself and I'm sure all of the residents of this town that we highly appreciate the work that's done by the members of this department. Certainly want to take care of them.
And we have incredible employees. And I do say that, you know, and throughout all of this, throughout the pandemic, throughout the growth, through working with, you know, specking out the trucks, the station, they've all had input. Everything's been positive. They understand the realities with this. These are not cheap projects, and they understand that. And I think they're trying to keep that in mind, that we're looking for a functional and a strong and a reliable building, not necessarily something that has to be a crown jewel. Yeah. We're not looking for that. We're very realistic with this.
Good.
And really, we couldn't have done any of this growth if it hadn't been for the employees and the relationship that we have with them. So,
well, I appreciate it. It's been great. And is there anything else you want to say to everybody out there? Or
no, again, just thanking everybody. You know, we're all going to get through these challenges. Yes. This has been one heck of a challenging year. My employees are in the absolute front line of this. There's a lot of employees, a lot of people are. The teachers are, this week, today, the kids actually just went back to school. I applaud the schools for the amount of work they did over the summer. I reached out actually to the school superintendent to thank him for that yesterday. We all have different challenges. We were one of the first ones to really hit it, and we're literally in the front row with dealing with the sick people in that. And that will continue until ultimately this eventually goes away. But everybody else has really begun to come into the fold on this as well. So this town has always worked very good together through any issue, any tragedy, or any challenge that we've had. And there's no doubt in my mind that the Abington residents, we're all going to help us each other through this challenge as well.
Good. Very good. Well, thank you. And thank everybody for watching. Again, we'll be doing many more of these segments, I hope. Myself, Kevin Tocci, Abington Cable. And I look forward to seeing you all on my next segment.